You've already learned quite a lot in the last 6 units. How to recognize challenging problems, the theory of NP completeness, and how you can nevertheless solve these challenging problems using exact techniques such as search trees, pre-processing, or fixed parameter tractability, or approximate methods, so approximation algorithms or randomization. So far, all of the problems that we have looked at have had one thing in common. If you gave the computer enough time and it has enough memory, then eventually you'll get an answer. So of course, if you have an intractable problem, say an NP-complete one or an NP-hard one, then of course you will have to wait a long, long time to get your answer. The computer is, at least in principle, able to give you an answer. In this unit, we will be looking at the ultimate limits of computation. What that means is, I will show you some problems that are not hard to solve, but that are impossible to solve. So the computer has no idea how to do this. And there's two surprising things waiting for you. First of all, these problems here are very simple, surprisingly simple. And the second thing is, although these problems are totally impossible to solve, actually your computer is probably solving them every day. So, some baffling things await you in this final unit of our course.